Do God got any place in you that are here with me today?
Amen.
I said, does God's word have any place in you in this place right now today?
Amen.
We were singing the song, Open the Door. The door that we're talking about, I know you might have forgot because these doors and some doors are closed and some are open, but the door is the door of your heart. When you come to church, there is a poise that you must carry. You must understand, God, I'm not here for fashion. I'm not here for show. I'm not here for folks to see me. I come here to open myself up so I can hear you talk to me. I understand I'm in a room with a bunch of people, but I know even if I was in the back of the room, if I was over on the other side of the room, because I'm in the room and my heart is open, somehow you'll find me. You'll go through a million. If I was in a room with a million people, you'll still locate me and find me because you would know me because my heart's open to you. Come here. I have an invitation. I invite you into me. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So therefore, when he says you have, there's no room in you, you say there's no room for God.
Come on.
Yes, Jesus.
My goodness.
Too many of us living lives that say, no room here.
Jesus.
But we talk about them folk now. Y'all see what? Say that we talking about them folk now. Because I believe all of you in here. At least, y'all didn't do that too right. I said at least something. I thought in here. Do I have a misunderstanding? In here, our hearts are open. God, you can find place in us. Are you here? Praise God. Now, so look at verse 39 because there's something interesting. There's an anointing coming on. After I get through this, it's coming on this church, and that's the anointing of the seer. You're going to see in the spirit, some of you, because God's going to release the anointing to be able to see.
Yes.
Everyone can't see in the spirit. Let's go a little.
Amen.
When the unseen becomes seen, that is by revelation that's given to you by the Spirit of God. The gifts of discernment is coming back to the church where we're discerning spirits. The enemy is constantly coming to try to take over or control the church of the living God. So we need the gift of discerning of spirits. Hallelujah. So here, verse 38. How many of y'all want to see? I'm not talking about see what happened. When you don't have a right way of thinking already, you can't expect to see right.
Come on, amen.
You got if you think wrong, you will see wrong.
Yes.
If you learn how to think right, you will see right.
Yes.
So many times, sight is not per se from your eyes; it's what you can see with your mind.
Yes.
That's why they have this statement, the glass is half empty or it's half full. It's based on how you see it.
Yes.
We were taught on Wednesday about perception, how y'all still with me. So check it out. It may look like I'm down at the bottom, but at least I got a nickel in my pocket. So I ain't really broke. I got a little bit of something. I got something rather than nothing. I thank God for this little bit I got because I know there's some more coming. Many times we are living with a mentality that this is it and we won't get no more. But I want to come and tell you something in the church of the living God that God can do exceedingly, abundantly, above what you can ask and even think. In other words, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor is it into the hearts of men that which God has prepared for them that love him. I just, the qualifying marker is that you love him. And I just believe I'm in a room with a set of people that love God. Are you here in the house?
Yes, we are.
love you than all that I'm feeling.
Yes.
Yes.
So look at now, verse 38. He said, I speak that which I have seen with my Father. Very interesting point. So somehow, in the course of Jesus on earth, he would have these times that him and the Father would get together, and the Father would start taking him through the tour of life.
Yeah, my goodness. Come on.
And he would show him stuff. Don't be surprised, because when you go back in time, he saw the Father create the heaven and the earth. So all God did is reconnect back what he already did when he was in the spirit, but now he had come in the flesh. And so he starts showing him that. He starts showing him how I'm going to raise the dead. I'm going to raise it, and because you're going to see me raise it, I'm going to show you can raise the dead too. You can't do some things until you see it. I'm talking about in the spirit. There's things you need to see. And so Jesus, he said, I do that which I see my Father. Sometimes when I've seen the Father showing me, I am restricted from doing.
Yeah.
Come on. My Lord. So I do that which I see my Father. And he said, God is showing it to me. I'm not making it up, conjuring up, making it up in my own mind. God's showing it to me.
Come on here.
When you go back in the Bible, you look at Moses. God showed him all the way back in Genesis. He wasn't born. It was way before the time of his birth. But God doesn't matter. Space and time don't restrict him. He'll go all the way back before you were born and show you stuff all the way back then. Because when I read in the book of Genesis, which Moses wrote it, how can a man write a book that he wasn't into? They say, well, there's the common language. Well, in a common language, it can get distorted and messed up, because people don't tell the same story the same way every time. And through the generation, but he didn't get it from people. He got it from Father God in heaven, and he showed him the panorama of the whole book of Genesis. And there was an interesting scripture in there, and it said that Sarah laughed inside of herself. That mesmerized my mind. How can we see her laugh inside of herself? And then he wrote what she was doing inside of herself, and what's not there?
Oh, y'all still suck. That's good. That's good.
So God knows the secret stuff of the heart, and when he gets to showing you some stuff, the problem is you show some people what he showed you and they can't understand it, and they'll suppress you and push you down because they don't understand.
Now,
the seer's anointing. The seer's anointing. God want to show some of you some stuff. But the devil is showing you before he showed you.
Come on.
You got to be able to distinguish this God or not.
Yes.
Is this a pizza dream or what?
Yes.
Come on. Is this a pizza scene I'm seeing or what?
Yes.
Y'all ain't here to praise God. Because you see somebody you want to hurt, praise God. Mm-hmm. Amen. Y'all might cry. What happened? I dropped a little something. Y'all okay. You see, that's some stuff you want to see. You can make it. You can make yourself to see it.
Oh, yeah.
But I ain't talking about what you're doing. I'm talking about what God is doing.
Yes.
I'm talking about what God is doing. Now, so let's go a little bit closer. So he said, I do that which I see my Father. Many of you here are going to start moving, and you're going to do like your father of this house.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
The Bible said in the book of Numbers that Moses was burdened over the care of the children of Israel, which was 1 million-some people. And all of a sudden, God said, I've got an antidote for you. I'm going to take the spirit that's on you, and I'm going to put it on the elders or the leaders of Israel.
Yes, right.
So let me try to help y'all a little bit. See, God had to put his spirit on the leadership of the house before it get to the people.
Yes.
And I believe there's a release when we inaugurated them the first of this year, that the spirit that was on me is now resting on them. And you also see it. And see, now it's time to line up and begin to flow.
Yes.
Hallelujah. There's an anointing. There's a change. There's a changing of the law. There's a shifting.
Yes. Thank you.
It's not just natural. It's supernatural.
Yes.
Are y'all still hearing?
Yes.
So he says again. He said here, he said, I speak that which I have seen with my Father. 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 Say that, with my Father.
With my Father.
There's some stuff God says, I want to show you not in a room with a bunch of people, but me and you.
Yeah.
Y'all still ain't hollering.
Yeah.
So, how many of y'all went to the movies?
Yeah.
Anybody ever went to the movies?
Yeah.
God said, I'm gonna show you a movie,
yeah,
and me and you gonna be the only one in the studio.
Come on, my God.
The only one in the theater.
Yes, yes.
And it's gonna be me and you. Mm-hmm. You got the center chair, and I'm gonna show you on the screen of your spirit. I'm gonna show you some things, some great and mighty things that you had never conceived before. I'm gonna show you some stuff. Why are you gonna show me? Because I want you to know, because we got a relationship. And in our relationship, I can show you stuff that other people don't know about, and if you ain't a blabbermouth,
come on, let's do it.
You'll learn it's between me and you. See, some people don't understand some things. Some things God gives you is for information.
Yes.
And some things he gives you is directives or instructions.
Yes.
So when you can't, I got to get out of this.
Come on, that's good.
Y'all, see, I have to figure out, and something because he's not a tattletale.
Right.
Y'all ought to know about that.
Yes.
Y'all ought to know about that. Y'all ought to know about that. You know, y'all, okay, let me help you there. You know some stuff that you just didn't want God to say. And he just slipped, he didn't say it, he didn't tell it. Go ahead, keep looking at me, don't worry about it. I know it's just us now, okay, don't worry about it. But he didn't tell it, because he kept our business private. Y'all ain't hear what I'm talking about. Because he loved you so, and he's so caring about you. And you know what? Oh, God, thank you. You know what he said? He said, I give you credit to a problem you already have already.
Yes. My goodness, come on.
You haven't qualified for it, but I'll give you credit in advance.
Come on, my God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
God will have you do some stuff that it's not time to do.
Yes. Yes, he will.
Let me.
Yes, he will.
Oh, okay. Y'all with me now? So let's go see, let's go to here, Romans chapter, let's go to chapter 2. Go ahead and turn to chapter 2, Romans chapter 2. Because the debate was about being a seed of Abraham. Y'all remember that when we were talking about that? Right? Now one of the things, and when we go into looking at it, is that the Jews are highly, they take it in high esteem of circumcision. And so therefore, now the circumcision is of the flesh or external. And the males, they would be circumcised as a token of the covenant. So therefore, if you don't go in covenant with God, you're gonna have to cut something.
Come on. Amen.
Let me go back
Amen.
In.
All right. Amen.
Now the sister said, oh, praise God. No. The New Testament said, there's not the cutting of the foreskin of the flesh, but now there's a cutting of the heart.
Yeah, yeah.
The true Jew is one that has been cut in the heart. They don't have excessive flesh and carnal nature. They are circumcised in their hearts.
Yeah, yeah.
And all the sisters say,
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, God bless you. All right, now, y'all still with me? Romans chapter 2. Look at verse number 28, if you would. Because if you're going to hook up with God, you're going to have to cut out that flesh.
Come on, that's it. Yeah.
That's good.
So true.
That's all he has to cut. Oh, thank you. Oh, I see scissors. I just saw scissors. I just see scissors. God wants you to go back and cut something. Cut it out. I see scissors.
Come on, Pastor.
Because I believe some of y'all serious up in here. Now, the scissors was a serious for.
Yes,
so the Pope ain't going to go and cut. He's giving you to cut out some stuff.
Yes.
It's excessive. It's not necessary.
Yes. Come on. That's good. That's good.
Look. Chapter 2, verse 28. He said, for he is not a Jew, which is one outwardly, neither is that circumcision, which is outwardly in the what? In the flesh. Watch this, verse 29. But he is a Jew. Say, he is a Jew.
He is a Jew.
Say, I am a Jew.
I am a Jew.
Which is one inwardly. And watch this now. The circumcision is that of the what? The heart. In the what? In the spirit. And not in the letter. Watch this. Whose praise is not of men, but of God. So the scissors and the stuff I'm gonna cut out isn't because I'll be caught by man.
Come on. Come on.
But I'm gonna cut it because I'm doing this because of God. The closer you get to loving God, the more you cut out. The less you move in love. For faith worketh by love. The more you move in faith, you'll start cutting out some stuff that's laying upon your heart. Because what the enemy is trying to do is put so much on your heart that your heart is troubled and your heart is stressed and your heart cannot have any peace. The rhythms are enigmatic. It's not flowing like it should. But God wants you to have peace. Jesus said, my peace, I am the Prince of Peace. So peace is a person as well as a source. He said, my peace. So therefore, Jesus can give you what the world does not give you. We used to sing that song that the world didn't give it to us and the world can't take it away. God's got some stuff for the church of the living God that the world can't even wrap their mind around. Some of them wondering right now because they had plans to kill you, had traps and snares for you, but you still ain't died. They're talking about you in hell. We thought we had killed them. We thought we had took her out, but she's still living and breathing because they misunderstand that the God you serve is the God of the resurrection. They didn't know you died because God brought life back into you so fast it snapped them up before they realized it. We tried to so bad. You know, they have to report back to devil. We did. We tried our best. Sir devil, we did all we could for them. And they still alive.
Thank you.
Go out there and do some more. But it's starting to get hard now because they don't care anymore.
No.
That's it.
Y'all not humble, but I didn't.
That's it.
Oh, God. Because see, for God I live. And for God I die. Because if it wasn't for the Lord who's on my side, see, I would have to care, but because the Lord is on my side, I cast my care to him, and I'm walking free without any cares.
Yes.
Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
Yes.
Come on.
Why is he saying that? Because he knows in life you're going to have stress.
Yes.
But he says, I will give you rest. See, some of y'all are stressing your own self.
Come on. That's it.
What am I stressed with? Changing some unchangeables.
Good, that's good.
God, there are some things that God is not going to change. Okay, let me give you all the scripture. 2 Corinthians chapter 12. When Paul, when he was being tormented by those demonic forces and that, and he prayed to God three times that he would be delivered from it. God said, no, I'm not going to deliver you. I'm just going to give you grace.
Yeah.
Some of y'all got to figure this out. Don't move my mountain. Just give me the strength to climb.
Come on.
Anybody know what I'm talking about? See, everybody want an escape route.
Come on.
But there's some people understand, no, I'm going to grow through this.
Yes.
I've been growing through this, but it's time for me to grow through this. God is trying to get you to grow up, praise God, because he got another battle that's waiting around for you. And see, you've taken too much time on this one issue. I'm tough. You're taking too much time, and so I'm trying to get you to this other thing, because every time you win a victory, you cause your brothers and sisters to be encouraged, and you terrorize hell. You must go on and grow, because I've got some more to show the wisdom of myself in you working beyond your expectations. So they think they know you, but they don't know you. That's why I've allowed some stuff to happen to you, because I know what I put in you. Man don't know what he put in. The devil don't know.
That's it.
So many people think they know you.
Come on. Come on. Yes. Come on.
You may know where I live.
Come on.
But you don't know me inside. In order to know me, God got to give you permission.
Woo!
You must perceive me.
Come on.
Man. The deeper you go, the less folk can find you.
Come on. That's it. That's it. That's good.
In the Lord is a hiding place.
Yes. My God.
More of him, less of me.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Y'all stay with me.
Yes.
So here, let's go. Let's go over to Genesis. I'm sorry. Go to Galatians. Go to Galatians. Chapter 3. Galatians chapter 3. Y'all still with me?
Yes.
Verse 29. God's good, isn't he?
Yes.
Y'all make me want to preach up in that. I feel like I got to hold this up now. Y'all doing something.
Come on, Pastor.
Y'all trying to get me started. Praise God. Sleep will do that to you. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. God's good, isn't he? Now say this to me. Jesus connects me to Abraham.
Abraham.
Or the Abrahamic blessing, I'm sorry. Say the Abrahamic blessing. Now, we're exploring and moving when we gave the title of doing what Abraham did. If we do what he did, we can get what he got.
Yes.
Amen.
There are some people that don't want to do what you do, but still get what you got. And they're wondering why it doesn't work. Because, darling, there's a price tag. You pay the price, you can have the merchandise. There's a whole lot of people, now check it out, because some of y'all, God has put all on your efforts. You're doing it so easily, and they're mesmerized. They try to copy, and they're struggling because there's no oil there. There's no lubricant, not to make so that the struggle is not even there, because God ain't calling you to struggle. He called to bless you.
Yes.
And to add no sorrow to you.
Yes.
Are you still with me?
Yes.
So therefore, we were getting a hold of this, so we're connected to that Abrahamic blessing through Jesus. Now let's look here. These, you know, we make statements, but now I'm understanding. Listen to this. These are legal laws. What I say, they're what? They're legal law. In the spirit, they are legal, documented by the word that is to be given to us. And let it be known, every law has the ability to enforce it. When a law is handed down in our natural government, if you break it, the police come and get you. Is that right? They enforce the law. I want to tell you that God want to enforce the half Abrahamic covenant that is full of blessing to the church of the living God. The church, listen, the whole church mouth don't live here anymore.
Come on.
That's it.
Let me say that again. The whole church mouth don't live here anymore.
That's it.
When you pour, you have no voice. God want to give you a voice so you can say something.
Yes.
I told y'all before, if we were going to get a pizza, and you know, pizza's $25, and there's five of us, and he said, I got my five, and the other one got their five, and we get down to the fifth person, he said, he ain't got his five. And then he got to talk about, I want pepperoni. He said, man, you ain't got no money, you ain't got no voice. Y'all still with me? You ain't got no say-so. All you can do is sit and enjoy our good grace if we want to give you it. Are y'all with me? Because we got to pick up the tab because of your lack. No more will the church have to keep picking up the tab of other people. Glory to God. Because we got to have someone else take it up for us, because we ain't got it to put in for our own self. God's going to give us a voice in this country among our kids, because God is trying to invade the nation of the United States with his people. We have a common knowledge. We have something we share, a custom, and that custom is the way of Almighty God. Not, listen, color doesn't matter.
Amen.
Yes. Customs do.
Yes. Wow. My goodness. Yes. My God. Glory.
or this, I jump in a little. I'm trying to take time. Y'all pushing me. Y'all pushing me. All right. Galatians chapter 3, verse 29. Now watch this. And if you be Christ's, are we Christ's?
Yeah.
Raise your hand if you're Christ's so I can check everything out. Okay, we're Christ's. Right? So he talking about us. Is that right? Okay, now watch this now. If you be Christ's, then are you what? So receiving Jesus connects you or hooks you up to Abraham. Y'all hearing about your hookup?
Yes.
You connected to Abraham. So therefore, there's a connection from Christ with Abraham that we've got to go back to check it out, because God, this is a legal document. This is a legal transaction that took place. But it's just like someone who say my father was Rockefeller and he had wrote out a will, and no one tells me what's my, and he wrote my name in it and got stuff for me. But if I don't know nothing that's mine, I'm going to be able to claim it. But I want to tell you, we're going to claim all the blessings of Abraham. We don't want to claim everything, because we realize that we connected to Abraham, and Abraham is a bad boy.
Come on, that's it.
Right now, the land of Israel, one of the richest lands around. They're all trying to get it. They're trying to take it out, because God is the only man and the only set of people, which were Jews, that gave them a land and told them, this is going to be yours. He never told none of the Gentiles, but he told it to the Jews. And I want to tell you, my brothers and sisters, that are Jews in the spirit, that God has some land for you. It belongs to you. He's already written it out. Nobody can touch it. Don't they want to get it? As long as you walk in obedience, you will possess your land.
Yes.
I y'all hear me?
Yes.
God got something for me.
Yes.
And when I'm going to get my, okay, I'm going to get what's mine. See what happened? Time is trying to wear you out.
Come on. That's it. That's it.
You know, time can be a benefit, and time can be torturous.
Yes.
If you're ever waiting in the waiting room trying to go see the doctor with a tooth, with something hurting you, praise God, time is against you.
Oh, yeah.
You want to hurry up time. You can't even stand. And most of the time, it's amazing. You won't stand 2 hours in church, but you'll stay in a hospital room 2 hours.
Oh, yeah.
To go to a doctor who later on, if you remember, you out there. Oh, I'm sorry. Nothing against doctors. It's just the way it is. And you're lucky if you can get an appointment.
Come on, that's it.
You're lucky if you can get an appointment, son.
Mm-hmm.
And then and it's amazing. You know, when you go in the room, praise God, they have the nurse do her little thing, and she walks out the room, then you wait a little later. See, you wait about an hour and a half to go see him, and then you gotta wait another 30 minutes before you really show up.
Right.
Let me get off the ground. I'm just talking about, you'll wait though.
Yes.
Yes, I'm gonna leave my body. It's taking too long. But we sit in here at church. It's too long. Because see, what happened is your belief system.
Come on.
Yeah.
No, let me go back. Your faith is in him. Because you got a problem, and he's going to tell you, I'm not against doctors. We love them. I got my own. And he's a Christian doctor, too. Praise God. We got him. But I want to tell you, I got a human doctor, but I also got a divine doctor. Because Jesus is my great physician. After this, because see, you always got to get a second opinion.
Amen.
Y'all just said amen. I know y'all just took that first one. That's it. That's going on right there. What he say, that's it. Ain't he a man?
Come on.
That's
it. Pastor Neil said something. He said, isn't that a practice? Ain't that what they call it? Ain't that what? Practice? This is what they practicing on. It's a practice. Now we're not against them. Please don't misunderstand. We love them. You got to know what's what though, because you get hoodwinked.
Come on, that's it.
When you tell them, no, I ain't gonna do that.
Right, that's it. All right.
Don't you? What?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yeah.
Because hold it. Wait till I agree. I'm not gonna take that.
Right.
I remember when my appendix was on burst. And I was in the hospital, and I was on the gurney, and they came to tell me. I said, Nick, you got to operate on me now. I said, no. For one thing, I've got to wrap my mind on what you just said. I got to have time. Hello, praise God. You know, holy, don't rush me. You're going to cut me and want me to rush because of what you said. Let me get my, so, you know, I didn't take too long, though. If you told